because it's a lockdown interview, Ewan, what I've been asking people at the end is, have they been learning any new skills, or have they got any tips for people how to deal with some of the restrictions? So have you been learning to play the guitar or learning the language or anything like that?
I've been doing a lot of, I think I've been doing a lot less, obviously schoolwork's been cut down, so I think I've done a lot more kind of outdoor exercise than I would have previously. I've been keeping a lot more sane. I've had this thing where before lockdown I was working very hard on loads of different projects, and I think that now that's been toned down, I've relaxed more and I've had more time to just kind of de-stress, because before lockdown there was a lot of work. I was going to election camps, I was going to up to Edinburgh twice a month to go and talk with Young Scott, and I think a lot of that have been toned down now, and I'm really excited when all that starts back up. But I think some of the top tips, I did this to Young Scott, and I think some of them were not looking at the news as much, because I've done that quite a lot, kind of watching the news quite a lot, and I think toning down on that and having more positive news stories and things like that, and reading more about into those rather than coronavirus updates every 10 minutes, because I feel that's quite a lot on the news. But I feel like also talking to your family about things if you're not feeling quite right, because everyone's kind of having that kind of time where we're going through where it's not quite the greatest scenario to be in. I haven't seen my friends in 2 months, and that had a huge impact on me. I'm really missing my friends, and I think there's been a big thing in the news and the coronavirus. It's not really affecting young people as much, but it definitely is, just not in the ways that people perceive it as affecting people. Because yes, we are probably less likely to be susceptible to the actual virus itself, but we are not as less susceptible to the impact of the virus that it's having, because we're also going to have to pick this up with the economy and things like that. When we are the adults and we are kind of in charge of the economy and things like that, I think it is really affecting us, and it's affecting my friends as well, because we don't know. We've just been told that we don't know yet if our exams will be on. I'm a new National 5 pupil. We've just went into S4, so I may not be sitting my National 5 exams next year. We don't know. We're on that kind of questionable time right now.
Yeah, there's been a lot of uncertainty for lots of people, you know, about what's going to happen with the economy and how it's going to impact on their lives, and especially young people, maybe about the future world of work. Although things like this, I think people using technology like this that they never used before. So I think we might need to think about how we work and how we interact slightly different than we did before. And I think you're right. In the beginning, you were so busy with things, you just get caught up in everything, and I think the lockdowns forced you to maybe take a step back and slow down. And sometimes I found that's on it well anyway. The pace of change has been really good for my mental well-being, I think. And I think, well, Elaine, you were getting distracted by a lot of things that maybe weren't as important now that you've had a chance to reevaluate. So I think we need to, when we come out of it, think about the good things and hold on to them, and also that there will be some big challenges. But I think that we've realised the value of our connections to each other, and that social interaction, and that's what's going to get us through those challenges. Yeah.